JVC, a worldwide consumer electronics company specializing in audio and video at the frontiers of technology. Newport Jazz 86.
I was a street musician for a while in New York, and for me that was a good way to get started, because what I was doing, my solo guitar, was already a complete performance unto itself. So it was easy for me to just get out there and just play, you know. And by and by, after I produced my first album in 1982, I had that to sell on the streets with me. So, you know, it wasn't just nickels and dimes. I was actually making as much as I would have made in clubs. What a lot of people don't realize is that If you do it right, you can play a guitar with just one hand. Because instead of plucking or strumming the strings, you use your hands to tap the strings against the frets, and that impact makes them vibrate. So you can play with just one hand, or you could have both of your hands playing. One could be doing one part, and another could be doing another part on the same neck. So So it's really the independence of the hands that brings the keyboard possibilities to guitar. Thank you.
When we were out sailing in Lake Pontchartrain in New Orleans, our number one sailing tape is Michael Frank's Skin Dive album.
I think Michael Frank's is great.
I like Michael Frank's because he's soothing to my spirit.
I think Michael Frank's is fabulous.
Okay, I like Michael Frank's unique style that he has with music. I mean, it's very soothing, it's got a little gusto to it, it's got a little groove to it.
When I'm 90, I still love Michael Frank's.
And now, Michael Frank's.
Love has locked us up, peaches. We're locked inside the zoo. Your bananas get thrown at me, and mine get thrown at you. Every night we fuss and fight like crazy people do. I guess love is always just love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, features. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Would I lie to you? Love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, features. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Do, do, do. Do you want my love, features? Do you want my rage? Do you merely like to see me shake my cage? Your papayas get thrown at me, mine get thrown at you. I guess love is always just love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Would I lie to you? Love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Stumble and eat the jungle until I've had my fill. Then you'll learn the truth, peaches. One and one ain't two. One and one is one and love is. Love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Would I lie to you? Love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do.
Quite normal childhood took Michael Frank's from the cradle to his early teen years, until the talent which would eventually establish him as a first-rate jazz performer began to drive him toward a full-fledged musical career.
Actually, I used to be a teacher, and I managed to segue into music from teaching. I got a part-time teaching job after I got out of college teaching at UCLA. and I was teaching a pretty interesting class on the history of popular song in America. And at the time, though, I didn't think too much of it. I didn't enjoy it too much. But while I was doing that, I got some work over at Warner Brothers Pictures. They asked me to do a little research on a picture they were making. And somehow I managed to get the job to write the score for the picture. And from there, I kind of sneaked in the side door at Warner Brothers Records.
Thank you.
Saturday, July 17, 1954, the crowds gathered on the tennis courts on the Newport Casino in Newport, Rhode Island, had no idea that they were sitting in on the beginning of an American tradition, the birth of the Newport Jazz Festivals. They'd come for a two-day series of jazz concerts starring what even then read like a who's who list of Hall of Fame jazz performers, including Billie Holiday, Stan Kenton, and Gene Krupa. Starting with that first concert and leading right up to this year's Newport JVC Jazz Festival, the legendary musicians who have performed at the festival have created a legacy of excellence for all who will follow. And in living testimony to the durability of that legacy is a performer who starred in that first concert and at this year's Newport Jazz Festival, Mr. Gerry Mulligan.
Thank you. With was, well, let's see, the bands, really. The big bands in the 30s and the 40s. And radio was an important medium for live music. Every night on the radio, you could hear bands from all over the country, and there were some wonderful bands then. And that was my influence. If I'd grown up on the Beatles and John Coltrane, maybe I would have been someplace else. And I'm also not interested in the future of jazz as an entity, because jazz is not an entity. Jazz is a bunch of individuals. What's happening now with the succeeding generations is that we have so much variety, it's even harder to identify jazz. And I'm glad that there are young musicians coming along who like the traditions as well as I do. And so that there is a hope that the traditions will survive and won't be swamped by the technology.
Newport Jazz 86 was made possible by JVC, a worldwide consumer electronics company specializing in audio and video at the frontiers of technology.
Economics and the Africans, Thursday night at 9.